excuse me. Hi peeps, Linda here. Today I'm going to be doing another journal page, and this is a mini challenge set by Mike over at Mission Inspiration on Facebook, and I'll put the link below. And the mini challenge is aquatic of water, an aquatic plant or animal, pond, aquarium or sea, creature either real or imaginary. So I'm going to go with under the sea, and that's going to be the name of this page. As always, I've given my journal page a coating of white gesso by Newton and at Winsor & Newton, and I'm going to first, using these bubbles by Tim Holtz, this is the circles, distress circles, I'm just going to place a few round the page first and put that to one side to dry. I'm going to be using the gel medium and just scrape a bit across the bubbles. I just want a few here and there before I paint over it. I'm just bringing them down, just down the page. Just a few hither and thither. And just down here. Just a few. Yeah. My stencil quick wipe. I don't want to destroy my stencil. And I've forgotten to bring my bowl of water, but hey ho, never mind. So I'm going to put that to one side for now, because I've torn strips of watercolour card, and these are going to be my seaweed. And I've also cut out the seaweed from Sweet Dixie Dyes. And I'm going to give them, I'm going to use PBO High Viscosity Acrylics. I've got Hooker's Green and I've got Cardamom Green Hue. Well, it's not cardamom, cadmium. I can never say that word. If I can get the lid off. Oh, there we are, it's coming. So I'm just going to put a little bit on my mat and get my brush and just give them a quick, don't have to be perfect, I'm just after colouring them. Nice green colour. I do like greens. I never used to, but I do now. Give it quickly. That's that one done. Put that to one side. I've had this once. When I saw the mini challenge set by Mike, I had an idea floating around in my head, and today I've managed to get some me time to have a play and do this. So that's that one. And I'll add a little bit of add a little bit of this to this. Just want a smidgen. Just mix the two colours together just to get tone the darkness down. And then just very quickly adding the paint to the strips that I've cut off from the watercolour card. It's one done. Very quick and easy. I'm hoping I've just got enough, I think. So I've just put these to one side now and just check that the bubbles are dry, and then I'm going to add some colour to my journal page. So that's them done. Clean my mess up. Just give it a quick blast with the heat gun. Okay, so for the sea, I'm going to be using a mixture of the iridescent green yellow and the iridescent green blue. They're PBO high viscosity acrylics, and I'm just going to them on the page with a baby wipe. So I'll cut this in half. I can use half for each. So I think I'm going to go in with the greeny yellow. Where the bubbles are, I'm just going to dab them on. Now I'm going to introduce some of the blue. a little bit more out. I'm really liking that. Hope you can see. It's really nice. So pleased with that. Now that's come out. It's almost got a shine to it. Can you see the shimmer? There we are. So I'm going to now give that a quick blast of the heat gun. Next, I've got these are rising bubbles from Designs by Ring. And I'm going to use, I just want these kind of in between. I'm only going to do them twice, but I really like these bubbles. I thought they would really work. Not using an acrylic block, I'm just going to do it again over the other side. This a bit further up. There we are. So I've got my rising bubbles. Just put that to one side. So there we have it. Next step is to adhere my seaweed. And so for that I'm going to be using a Pritt stick. Now before that I add the other ones, what I want to do, I've got some sand, and I'm just going to put some of this gel medium along the bottom. I'm just going to add it with my spatula. The sand will hopefully adhere to this, but it's an experiment. I know I've not put the other seaweed on yet, but I want to just prep this first. So what I'll do now, just while that is still a bit damp, I'm just going to add the other seaweeds. Now what I'm going to do is just sprinkle some sand onto the that over. Looking good. Sure, if you can see it, can you see the sand along the bottom? That looks good. So I'll put this back in here, hopefully without spilling it everywhere. Always handy to have a bag of sand in your craft room. You never know when they become useful. Right, while that's setting, I'm just going to pop that to one side and I've got some little shells that I want to just give a paint. I've got this seahorse which is going to paint, and I've also got some die cut shells. These are from Sweet Dixie, the dies. And I'm going to paint the seahorse in this iridescent green yellow. And I've got Naples yellow, which are Dale Rowney, and burnt umber. And I just want to that might be a bit too much. Surprising what you find in your craft stash when you have a sort out. So I'm just going to give these a quick paint. Don't have to be perfect. Just want to put a striation of, change the colour up a bit, tone it down with the brown. So can you see? So I'm going to do that with all three of them. Only thing is, they're sticking to my fingers, but I don't want them perfect. I want a little bit of white showing. These dies out, these shells and that out in the watercolor card as well. So I will fast forward to the end, because I know you will not want to sit here and watch me colouring. It's like watching paint dry. So I'll catch you all at the end when they're all done. Okay, so everything's dry now, and I'm just going to start adding bits to the bottom of the where the sand is. Put them in a cluster. And put that on there. So get my prit stick out. I'm not going to glue all of it. I just want the bottom bit. I want a bit of dimension on this. And then I'm going to use some of the gel medium on the so it sticks. This one as well. Whoops. So there we are. That's that bit done. And this is my seahorse, and what I've done is I've used the green yellow, and then I've gone over it with turquoise and just highlighted the fins. But I just want to make sure that that is set dry, and I'll just give it a quick blast. Yeah, that's dry now, so I'll get some prit stick on it and then stick it to the page. Not wanting to stick. Maybe if I just hold it for a bit while it... There we are, it's done now. Just needed a bit of pressure. There we are. So all that's left for me to do is write the under the sea, beg your pardon, and for that I'm going to be using my Pilot High Tech V5 Extra Fine, and I'm just going to write it here, I think. Can't make up my mind. just to finish off, I'm just going to go round the edges with some titanium white. Again, this is a PBO high viscosity. Thought of doing black, but changed my mind. Just going to add some white. I always do black. Oops, I need to cut that off. Little bit more. Finish off. Right, so yeah. So I can safely say that is my mini mission completed. I hope you can see it. As always with my videos, I will have still photographs, close-up photographs of the finished page, but I really enjoyed this little mini mission, so thanks very much, Mike. If you've enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up and share with your friends, and also please subscribe. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye bye.